from Surah Yunus to this Surah Al-Anbiya. These are 12 surahs and subdivided into 4 subgroups of 3 surahs. Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, Surah Yusuf, one subgroup. Surah Ra'd, Surah Ibrahim, Surah Hijr, second subgroup. Surah Al-Nahl, Surah Bani Israel, Surah Al-Kahf, third group. Surah Maryam, Surah Taha, Surah Al-Anbiya, fourth group. Now we come to Surah Taha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Taha. It is beginning with 2 letters. And they say that this is the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yasin, they say it is name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Taha, this is also, they say, it's an opinion. Although I don't agree with it. Anyhow, it's an opinion, I've told you. مَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لِتَشْقَى. Oh Muhammad, we have not sent down this Qur'an upon you so that you should be distressed or you should be a failure or doomed. Success will come to you. In the long run, you will be supreme. Your enemies, they will have to bow down before you. This Qur'an has come, as we have read in Surah Bani Israel, وَبِالْحَقِّ أَنزَلْنَاهُ وَبِالْحَقِّ نَزَلْ. This book has come down with the truth and the final decision it will give. People will be punished. They will get their chastisement. And Muhammad and his companions will triumph. إِلَّا تَذْكِرَةً لِمَنْ يَخْشَى. We have sent down it as an admonition, a reminding to those who fear. تَنْزِيلًا مِمَّنْ خَلَقَ الْأَرْضَ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ الْعُلَى. And it has been sent down from the one who created the earth and all the heavens, which are very high. Ar-Rahmanu ala al-arshi istawa. Again, he is Ar-Rahman. He is Ar-Rahman. He is the compassionate. And he has ascended the throne of this kingdom, of this universe. Lahuma fi samawati wa fil ard. To him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. Wa ma baynahuma. And whatever is in between them. Wa ma taht as-sara. And whatever is beneath the soil, beneath this earth. وَإِن تَجْهَرْ بِالْقَوْلِ. Now if you want to talk to him loudly, you want to say your prayer loudly, فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. Okay, you can do it if you like so. But he knows every hidden thing, and even the most hidden thing, most secret things, he knows. He knows what you are saying to yourself in your heart. So you can talk to us. Heart to heart. It's not necessary that you use your tongue, but it's better to use the tongue. And you should raise the voice so that you hear also. So that, you know, your senses participate. More senses participate. When you are communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so your ears also should hear what you are saying. And that is why, you know, reading Quran from the Mushaf, it is more important than just by, you know, heart. A hafiz is only, you know, by his memory he is reading. No, it's more afzal to see, because now your eyes are also participating. They are seeing the text of the Quran. وَإِنْ تَجْهَرْ بِالْقَوْلِ فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ لَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah is He. There is no Lord except Him. And to Him belong all the good names. All the good attributes, all the good names. وَحَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى. Now this surah is very unique. Just like Surah Yusuf. Surah Yusuf contains the story of one prophet from the beginning till the end. This is another example. It has 8 sections. But the 5 sections are devoted to the story of Moses alayhi salatu wasalam, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And there is a very interesting coincidence. With Yusuf alayhi salam is connected how the children of Israel entered Egypt. They entered Egypt in the time of Yusuf alayhi salam. And with Moses, they came out. So one full surah for Yusuf, We have already read Surah to Yusuf, a nearly full surah. This is devoted to the history of Hazrat Musa. وَهَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَىٰ? Has the news of Moses come to you? إِذْرَعَ نَارًا. Now this is the incident when he was coming back from Madian. He had married there. He had served the Sheikh over there for 8 or 10 years. And then he had married his daughter. And now he was returning to Egypt. Remaining nearly for 10 years in exile. He had run away from Egypt because a person was killed. Unintentionally, he was killed by him. But then, you know, the law could take this course. So he had to run for his life. So he came to Madian. And there, you know, he remained there for a sheikh. People say he was Shu'aib alayhi salatu wasalam, but some people differ, and I do differ. He's not Shu'aib. He was some other sheikh. And then now he was going back to Egypt with his family. In the way they were lost, it was a dark and very cold night. He and his family and some, you know, herd of the goats and sheep he was going. Israr and Haram, suddenly he saw fire. فَقَالَ لِأَهْلِهِ. So he said to his family, Imkusu, you stay here. Inni anastu nara. I have seen fire. لَعَلِّي آتِيكُ مِنْهَا بِقَبَسٍ. Maybe that I bring to you from there a burning coal so that we can ignite a fire over here. أَوْ أَجِدُ عَلَى النَّارِ هُدَى. And also it is possible that when I go there where there is fire burning, then I can get guidance. We are lost. The way we shall know which way we should go. فَلَمَّا أَتَى. When he came to that bush from which, you know, fire was coming, نُودِيَ يَا مُوسَىٰ. He was called by name, O Musa, إِنِّي أَنَا رَبُّكَ فَخْلَىٰ نَعْلَيْكَ. I am your Lord. So take off your shoes. إِنَّكَ بِالْوَادِ الْمُقَدَّسِ الطُّوَىٰ. Because you are now in the sacred valley of Tua. وَأَنَا اخْتَرْتُكَ. And I have chosen you for a mission. فَاسْتَمِعْ لِمَا يُوحَىٰ. So listen, what is being revealed to you, what is being said to you. Now first of the revelations, a very grand way of expressing the Tawheed of Allah in this surah. Rather I should say in the whole of Quran. إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدْنِي. I am the one, there is no God except me. So you have to worship me and obey me. وَاقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. And establish prayer for my remembrance. First command. Allama Iqbal calls it the big I am. Allah is also an ego, I. We have also an ego. I say I, you say I. But our ego, ourself, is very small. Finite ego. And that is the infinite ego, the great I am. إِنَّنِي أَنَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا. He has this ayah in his mind when he says that. The great I am. In the Saat Atiyatun, number 2, that fifth hour, the doomsday, is bound to come. أَقَادُ أُخْفِيهَا. I will keep it hiding. لِتُجْدَى كُلُّ نَصْرٍ بِمَا تَسْعَى. So that every person, every soul is rewarded fully for whatever he or she has endeavored. فَلَا يَسُبْنَنَّكَ عَنْهَا. مَنْ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِهَا. So see to it that whosoever does not believe in this akhira, in this qiyamah, in this resurrection, he doesn't prevent you also from believing in it. وَتَّبَى هَوَاهُ. And he is only following his lusts and desires of his id or libido. فَتَرْضَى. If you do this, you will perish. وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينَكَ يَا مُوسَىٰ. O Musa, what is that in your right hand? قَالَ هِيَ عَصَاءِ. Said, this is my staff. أَتَوَكَّوْ عَلَيْهَا. I lean on it. وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَىٰ غَنَمِي. And I beat down these for my goats, sheep. وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَعَارِبَ أُخْرَىٰ. And in this, I have other purposes to serve. This can be my weapon of defense for anybody if he attacks me, and so on and so forth. قَالَ Alqiha ya Musa. Allah said, okay, throw it down. Falqaha. He threw it down. Faiza hiya hayyatun tas'a. Suddenly, it became a serpent, a snake, running very fast. قَالَ خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ. At another place, there is a mention. فَعَوْجَسَ فِي نَفْسِهِ خِيفَةً مُوسَى. Musa found in his heart, خوف, fear. What has happened? A snake, a serpent. But Allah said, خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ. Hold it back. And don't fear. سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُخْرَى. We shall restore it to its former state. وَضْمُمْ يَدَكَ إِلَىٰ جَنَاحِكَ. And press your hand towards your side. تَخْرُجْ بَيْضَىٰ. When you take it out, it will be white, shining. مِنْ غَيْرِ سُوءٍ آيَةً أُخْرَىٰ. This will be shining, white, like sun, but not due to any disease. And this is the second sign that we have given you. First, the staff changing into snake or serpent. Second, this hand, when he pressed it to his side and then took out, it was shining like a sun. لِنُرِيَكَ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا الْكُبْرَىٰ. And this was so as we should show you our big signs. And what is all this for? اِذْهَبْ إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ تَغَىٰ. Now go to Fir'aun. Surely he has exceeded all bounds, all limits. He's arrogant. He's cruel. He's tyrant. So you have to go to him. قَالَ رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي. Now Musa prayed. Oh my Lord, open my chest for me. وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي. And make my mission easy for me. وَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِّن لِّسَانِي. And lose the knot which is there in my tongue. يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. So that they can understand what I say. وَجَعَلْ وَزِيرًا مِّنْ أَهْلِي. And appoint from my own family a helper, a minister, هارون آخي. And I suggest he should be my brother هارون. أُشْدُدْ بِهِ أَذْرِي. Strengthen my back with him, with his support. وَاشْرِكُ فِي أَمْرِي. And associate him in my mission. كَيْ نُصَبِّحْكَ كَسِيرًا. So that we together, both of us, we glorify you much. وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَسِيرًا. And remember you much. إِنَّكَ كُنْتَ بِنَا بَصِيرًا. Verily, you are seeing all our conditions. قَالَ قَدْ أُوتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى. Allah said, O Musa, your request is granted. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَىٰ. And we had given you another blessing when we said to your mother, what is being revealed now? Now when he was born, by the command and order of Fir'aun, all the male children were being slaughtered. So the mother of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, the wahi came to her that you put this baby, you know, in a basket or something of that sort, a chest, and then put that chest in the Nile, in the river. So that is now Allah mentioning. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَىٰ. And we had conferred a very big favor on you once before also. إِذْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ مَا يُوحَىٰ. When we revealed to your mother, what is being revealed to you now? أَنِقْذِفِيهِ بِالْتَابُوتِ. That cast him into a chest. فَقْذِفِيهِ فِي الْيَمِّ. Put that chest in the river. فَلْيُلْقِهِ الْيَمُّ بِالسَّاحِلِ. And this chest will throw it, this river will throw this chest on the coast of the river. يَأْخُذْهُ عَدُوٌّ لِّي وَعَدُوٌّ لَّهُ. And then he will be taken by a person who is my enemy and his enemy. Fir'aun. وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِّنِّي. And I endued you with love from me. There was a reflection of divine love on the face of Hazrat Musa. Whosoever saw him, he became loving him. So that is why he was saved. And you know the people of Fir'aun, they were deciding to kill him. They had recognized it's a Hebrew child. It's from Bani Israel. It was clear absolutely for them from the very beginning. But then, you know, the wife of Pharaoh, Bible says daughter of Pharaoh, but our tradition say wife of Pharaoh. He said, no, we shall take him, adopt him as our son. We don't have any son. They had no son till that time, Pharaoh and his wife. And this wife was also Israelite. So she has had love for the baby also. And then, Quratun li wa lak, he will be a coolness of eyes for me and you. So when wife is requesting, and she was a beloved wife of Pharaoh, so he stopped. And himself, Musa, you know, he had that reflection of divine love. Whosoever saw him, he started loving him. وَعَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي وَلَتُسْنَى عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي, so that you should be brought up before my eyes. استمشي أختك, when your sister was walking, when you know the water of Nile was taking the chest, the sister was going on the coast and watching what happens. And when this chest reached the palace of Pharaoh, she went there. And she said, استمشي أختك فتقول هل أدلكم على من يكفله. Now what happened? Many women were called for suckling this child. He must have been someone to suckle her, suckle him, but he never took, you know, in his own mouth, never took into the mammary glands of any woman in his mouth. So it was a problem. How will he keep alive? Now the sister said, if you like, these details are given in other parts of Quran. You know, the mention of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam is the maximum in Quran regarding all the prophets and the messengers of Allah. 1/13 of the whole Quran consists of the story of Musa alayhi salam. 555 ayat out of 6,500 ayat. They relate to Musa alayhi salam. So she said, Hal adullukum ala man yakfulu? Should I lead to you a family? To you, that can keep this child for you. فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمَّكَ, in this way, we return you to your mother, كَيْتَقَرَّعَيْنُهَا, so that her eyes remain cool. وَلَا تَحْزَنَ, and she should not grieve. وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا, we shall read this story in detail in Surah Al-Qasas. But here, it's a summary. But then you killed a human being. فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ الْغَمِّ, we saved you, delivered you from the grief. وَفَتَنَّاكَ فَتُونَ, and then we kept on trying you in different ways. فَلَبِسْتَ سِنِينَ فِي أَهْلِ مَدْيَنَ, then you ran away from Egypt. You stayed with the people of Madian for a number of years. ثُمَّ جَيْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرٍ يَا مُوسَىٰ, and then you have come over here by the destiny that we fixed. You have not come yourself. It's the destiny, our destiny. We had decided it. We have been watching you through all this period. And we have prepared you. وَاسْتَنَاتُكَ لِنَفْسِي, very beautiful words. I have prepared you, chosen you for myself. So, a very heavy mission is going to be entrusted to you. ثُمَّ جَيْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرِي يَا مُوسَىٰ, تَقْدِير. تَقْدِير has brought you over here. Our command. And we have prepared you specially for this purpose. Izabanta Bahuka Beayati. Now go you and your brother with my signs, miracles. Walataniya physically, and don't be slack in remembering me. Izhaba ila Fir'auna innahu tagha. Now go both of you to Fir'aun. Verily, he has become very tyrant. فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيَّنًا, but say to him, you both, very gentle word. لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُهُ يَخْشَى, maybe perchance he gets the admonition or he gets the fear of Allah in his heart. Don't be harsh. Talk to him gently. Now this is very important. A muballigh and da'i shouldn't be harsh. He should be very soft in his address. Kala Rabbana innana nakhafu. Both of them said, Musa and Harun, O our Lord, we fear, an yafruta alayna, that he might hasten against us. He might take any step against us. Aw an yatgha, or he becomes a transgressor against us. Kala la takhafa. Allah said, don't fear you both. Innani ma'akuma. Verily I am with you. Don't fear. Innani ma'akuma asma'u wa ara. I'll be listening to everything. I'll be seeing everything. Fatiyahu, now go. Reach him. Faqula. And both of you should say, Inna rasula rabbika. We both are the messengers of your Lord. Farsil ma'ana bani Israel. Now allow the children of Israel to go with us. They are not the sons of this soil. They came from Palestine in the time of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. And they were settled here by the king of that time. And Hazrat Yusuf also was the Aziz of Misr, was a big authority in that kingdom. But now nearly 400 years had passed. That was actually the time of the Hyksos kings. He was not a Firaun. He was not a local Egyptian king at the time of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. They were the Hyksos kings. Amalites, Amalka. Amalka had invaded Egypt and they were reigning at the time of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. And they were from the Arabian desert. So actually they welcomed Bani Israel, settled here. And they, you know, favored them. So they prospered. It's a 12 families had reached over there, and after 400 years there were 600,000 in number at the time of Exodus, 1400 years before Christ. Nearly 400 or 500 years had passed, and they prospered and multiplied in number. So now, but then there was a revolt against those Hyksos kings. They were, you know, beaten away, and now it was the local son of the soil. Now they were the Egyptians who were ruling, the Firaun dynasty. So now they were against these Bani Israel because they were the favorites of the former kings. So now this is the nationalism, simple nationalism. Just as you know, the Biharis in East Pakistan, in the same way, these Bani Israel were treated as foreigners and they were, you know, persecuted like anything. Now Hazrat Musa said, let them go back. Don't persecute them. Inna Rasula Rabbika. Fakula inna Rasula Rabbika Farsil Maana Bani Israel Awala Tuazibhum. Don't persecute them. Qad jaynaka bi ayatin min Rabbik. And look, we have come to you with a sign from your Lord. Wassalamu ala mani taba'al huda. And peace would be upon them, upon those who follow the guidance. If you follow, if you accept what we are saying, then there will be peace for you. Inna qad uhiya ilayna. This has been revealed to us. Anna al-azaba, that the chastisement would come. Ala man kazzaba wa tawalla. Whosoever belies us and whosoever turns his face away from what we are saying. Qala faman rabbukuma ya Musa. Now Fir'aun asks, who is your Lord, O Musa? I don't know any Lord except myself. I am the Lord of Egypt. Ana rabbukum al-ala. I am the Lord of Egypt. Alaysa li mulku Misr wa hadhihi al-anharu tajri min tahti. Is not the kingdom and government of Egypt under me? And all the irrigation system is controlled by me? Who is this your Lord who has sent you? Qala famar rabbukum ya Musa. And please remember, Musa was like an elder brother to this Fir'aun. Because this Fir'aun now, he was the son of that Fir'aun in whose time Hazrat Musa as an infant came to that palace. But later on, Allah gave him also a son. And this was his real son. But when Moses was also there in the palace, so they too were like brothers. This Fir'aun was like younger brother to Hazrat Musa. Hazrat Musa was like elder brother to this Fir'aun. Because now the old Firaun, you know, he had abdicated due to old age. And he had given over the government to this son of his. So this son of his, who was like a younger brother to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, now this conversation is going between them. قَالَ فَمَرْ رَبُّكُمْ عَيَا مُوسَىٰ Who is your Lord, O Moses? قَالَ رَبُّنَ الَّذِي آتَى كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلْقَهُ ثُمَّ هَدَىٰ Hazrat Musa said, our Lord is the one who gave every creation its existence and then guided it. قَالَ فَمَا بَالُ الْقُرُونِ الْأُولَىٰ A very intelligent question that he put. Then what will happen to the former generations? If you are true, if a true Lord God has sent you, maybe I accept you and I will be saved. What about my father and my forefathers and my grandfather? What will happen to them? Now, if we were there, we would say they are all in the hell. But Moses didn't say that. So what he said? قَالَ عِلْمُهَا إِنَّ رَبِّي فِي كِتَابٍ The knowledge of the former generations is in my Lord in a book. لَا يَضِلُّ رَبِّي وَلَا يَنْسَى My Lord neither errs nor forgets. What about you? I have come to you. Talk about yourself. الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ بَهْدًا Our Lord is the one who has made this land for you as cradle. وَسَلَكَ لَكُمْ فِيهَا سُبُلًا And threaded in this earth pathways for you. وَأَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً And sent down from the heaven water. فَأَخْرَجْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِنْ نَبَاتٍ شَتَّى And with this water, we have brought out from this earth all the plants of different kinds. كُلُوا Eat you وَرَعَوْا أَنْعَامَكُمْ And pasture your cattle also. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِّأُولِي النُّهَى And these are the signs for those people who have the faculty of reasoning. مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ From this earth we have created you. وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ And to this earth we shall take you again. When you die, you will be buried in it. وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً نُخْرَى And from this earth we shall take you out once more. وَلَقَدْ أَرَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا كُلَّهَا فَكَذَّبَ وَأَبَى We showed to him, to Fir'aun, all the signs. But he denied all them, belied them and refused to accept. قَالَ جَيْتَنَا لِتُخْرِجَنَا مِنْ أَرْضِنَا بِسَهْرِكَ مِنْ أَرْضِنَا بِسَهْرِكَ يَا مُوسَى He said, O Musa, have you come so as you want to drive us out of this land of ours with your sorcery? فَلَنَاتِيَنَّكَ بِسَهْرٍ مِسْلِهِ So now we shall confront you with sorcery of this type. We shall call magicians. And you will have to have, you know, a test. فَجْعَلْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكَ مَوْعِدًا So fix a time between you and us. لَا نُخْلِفُهُ نَحْنُ Neither we shall go back on that, وَلَا أَنْتَ And also you don't go back for that fixed time. مَكَانًا سُوَا And this should be in a very open ground. People should gather. You should produce what you have. You say these are miracles from Allah. We say this is magic. This is sorcery. Now we are calling our magicians. And now you will have to play a match against them. قَالَ مَوْعِدُكُمْ يَوْمَ الزِّينَةِ He said, okay. The time fixed for you is the day of our annual feast. Maybe some Eid they used to celebrate. وَأَنْ يُحْشَرَ النَّاسُ ضُحَى And call that people should gather before noon. فَتَوَلَّى فِرْعَوْنُ So Fir'aun turned his back فَجَمَعَ كَيْدَهُ And he gathered and devised the plot and all the scheme ثُمَّ أَتَى And then came for the confrontation. Now people have gathered, thousands of them. Open field. Fir'aun is there. His chieftains are there. On the other side, Musa and Harun are standing. And there are some magicians which have been brought from all the corners of the whole country. قال لهم موسى ويلكم. موسى said to them, to the magicians, ويلكم لا تفتروا على الله كذبا. Woe to you, don't forge a lie against Allah. فيسحقكم, so that there comes an azab. يسحقكم بعذاب, he exterminate you with a chastisement. وقد خاب من افترى, and definitely whosoever forges a lie, he is to lose. فتنازعوا امرهم بينهم. Now this speech of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam impressed them, so they now debated. There was difference. Some said we should go and confront him. Others said no, he doesn't seem to be a magician, he seems to be something else, so it's not good for us to go and confront him. فتنازعوا امرهم بينهم واسروا النجوى. They debated their matter among them, and they secretly counseled and consulted each other. قالوا, now Fir'aun and his chieftain said to these magicians, sorcerers, قالوا إن هذان لساحران يريدان أن يخرجاكم من أرضكم بسحرهما ويذهبا بطريقتكم المثلى. He said, these two persons, Musa and Harun, they are nothing but two magicians, sorcerers. And they want to drive you out from your land, your country, with their magic and sorcery. And they want to finish your ideal culture and social order. A very political speech which Surah made. Our culture is ideal. Our system, our kingdom, our traditions. Now these two persons, you know, they have learned some magic from somewhere, and they want that we should be in awe. We should run and give the land to them. فَاجْمِعُوا كَيْدَكُمْ. So gather all your skills. ثُمَّ أَتُوا صَفَّا. And then come as a rank before them. وَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْيَوْمَ مَنِ اسْتَعَلَى. And today, whosoever succeeds, then he is actually who is above everything, everyone. قَالُوا. Now the magicians came forward on this persuasion. قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى. They said, oh Musa, إِمَّا أَن تُلْقِيَ وَإِمَّا أَن نَكُونَ أَوَّلَ مَنْ أَلْقَى. Will you cast down first, or should we be the first to cast down? You produce what you have, or we produce what we have. قَالَ مَنْ أَلْقُوا. Musa said, okay, you go ahead and you present what you have. Cast down. فَإِذَا حِبَالُهُمْ وَعِسِيُّهُمْ يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سَهْرِهِمْ أَنَّهَا تَسْعَى. Suddenly, their ropes and their staffs appear to Musa alayhi salam as if they are moving like snakes. The same thing, the staff of Musa becoming a snake. But with this sorcery also, they produce some effect on the sight of the people. You see, we call nazar bandi. Somehow they could capture the sight of the people, and it appeared to them, including Musa alayhi salam, he also thought that these are moving snakes. So awjasa fi nafsihi khifatan Musa. So Musa conceived a fear in his mind. Qulna la takhaf innaka antal a'la. We said, don't have any fear. You will be supreme. Walqa ma fi yaminik. Now you cast what you have in your right hand. تَلْقَفُ مَا صَنَعُوا. It will swallow everything that they have produced. إِنَّمَا صَنَعُوا كَيْدُ السَّاحِرِ. What they have presented is only the presentation and skill of a sorcerer. وَلَا يُفْلِحُ السَّاحِرُ حَيْثُ أَتَى. And a sorcerer and a magician cannot be successful from where, whichever side he might have come. وَأُلْقِيَ السَّحْرَةُ سُجَّدًا. Now the magicians or the sorcerers were as if made to bow down. The ulqiya, this is majhul, not maruf. Not that the magicians bowed down and prostrated, but it appeared as if someone had compelled them to bow down. فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحْرَةُ سُجَّدًا. In prostration, قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ هَارُونَ وَمُوسَى. And they said, we believe in the Lord of Harun and Musa. Now why? This is very important to understand. the magicians very well knew the limits of the magic. Just as a scientist today knows what is the limit to which our science has reached. If there is some big leap, well, they would say it is something unnatural or supernatural. They know the limits. Limits of the sciences, limits of the technologies. Maybe tomorrow you go forward, but today there is a limit. You can't cross that limit. So now the common people couldn't differentiate, because they saw it's the same thing, the staff of Musa turning into a serpent, and the ropes and staffs of these magicians turning into snakes. What's the difference? So for a layman, there was no difference. But for the magicians and the sorcerers, they knew the difference. That this is not sorcery, it is something else. Shay digar hai, it's something else. فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحْرَةُ سُجَّدًا قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ مُوسَى هَارُونَ وَمُوسَى We come to believe in the Lord of Harun and Moses. قَالَ آمَنْتُمْ لَهُ قَبْلَ أَنْ أَذَنَ لَكُمْ Now Pharaoh said, you come to believe in him before I allow you to do it? I'm the king, I'm the emperor. How dare you without my permission? And you are declaring that you believe in Moses? إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرُكُمْ Now this is the diplomacy. A politician as he was. Now he suddenly has this idea, a very intelligent idea. إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرُكُمُ الَّذِي عَلَّمَكُمُ السِّحْرَ Actually this Musa is your guru, is your teacher who has taught you this magic. And now this is your collaboration. You have done this with mutual understanding. فَلَأُقَطِّعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ I will chop away your hands, وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ and your feet, مِنْ خِلَافٍ from opposite sides, وَلَأُصَلِّبَنَّكُمْ فِي جُزُوِ النَّخْلِ And then I shall crucify you in the trunks of the palm trees, وَلَتَعْلَمُنَّ أَيُّنَا أَشَدُّ عَذَابًا وَأَبْقَى And you will come to know who amongst us, me or Musa, they are more in chastisement and more abiding. قَالُوا لَن نُوصِلَكَ عَلَى مَا جَانَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ They said, we are not going to prefer you over what clear teaching has come to us. We have come to see the truth. This is not magic. This is not sorcery. This is something else. Now this truth has dawned on us. Now your threats, they can't prevent us. لَن نُوصِلَكَ عَلَى مَا جَانَا Whatever has come to us from these بَيِّنَاتِ We are not going to prefer you to them. وَالَّذِي فَتَرَنَا And we are not going to prefer to you to the one who created us. فَقْزِبَانْ تَقَاسْ So you command whatever command you want to make. إِنَّمَا تَخْزِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا You can take any decision only for this life of this world. What will you do? Kill us? Okay. We have to die. If not today, tomorrow. If not tomorrow, day after. Kill us. But that life is the everlasting life. We are not going to barter it away for this temporary abode of this world. إِنَّمَا تَغْزِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا إِنَّا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّنَا لِيَغْفِرَ لَنَا خَطَايَانَا We believe in our Lord so that He forgives us our discrepancies and sins. وَمَا أَكْرَحْتَنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنَ السَّحْرِ And you know, you compelled us to come and confront Musa in this, you know, test of this magic. وَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى Allah is the one who is much better, much higher, and He is the one who will remain, who is abiding. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعْتِ رَبَّهُ مُجْرِمًا Verily, whosoever comes to his Lord as an evildoer, فَإِنَّ لَهُ جَهَنَّمَ يَمُوتُ لَا يَمُوتُ فِيهَا وَلَا يَحْيَا For him will be hell. In that, in the hell, he will not be living, nor death will come. Between life and death, neither living nor dead. لَا يَمُوتُ فِيهَا وَلَا يَحْيَا وَمَنْ يَعْتِهِ مُؤْمِنًا And whosoever comes to him as a mu'min, as a believer, قَدْ عَمِلَ الصَّالِحَاتِ But note, everywhere where there is a mention of Iman, Amal Salih is also mentioned. Whosoever comes to him, while he was a mu'min, he was a believer. But not only a mu'min, قَدْ عَمِلَ الصَّالِحَاتِ He had done good deeds. فَأُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الدَّرَجَاتُ الْعُلَىٰ For them will be very high ranks in the paradise. جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِ الْأَنْهَارِ Gardens of perpetuity and bliss. And rivers will be flowing underneath them. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا And they will remain there forever. وَذَٰلِكَ جَزَاءُ مَنْ تَزَكَّى And this is going to be the reward of those who purify their souls. وَدْعَاهِنَا إِلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ Now, a long time has passed. This was the first confrontation. Now, so many years have passed. This confrontation between Musa on the one side and Firaun on the other side. Now, the last, the end. وَلَقَدْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ We revealed and sent them a revelation, command to Musa, through Wahi, and أَسْرِ بِعِبَادِي That you go out with my bondsmen, Bani Israel, in the night. Leave the place. There was a program chalked out at certain date, at certain that time. We shall all come out and go towards Sinai. And أَسْرِ بِعِبَادِي فَضْلِبْ لَهُمْ طَرِيقًا فِي الْبَحْرِ يَبَسَى And strike for them a dry path in the sea. لا تخاف دركم ولا تخشى Don't fear that you will be overtaken and don't be afraid. فَأَتْبَاهُمْ فِرْعَوْنُ بِجُنُودِهِ Now Fir'aun followed them with his armies, hosts. فَغَشِيَهُمْ مِنَ الْيَمِّ مَا غَشِيَهُمْ Then covered them from that sea, what covered them? When they were drowned, water was covering them. So Musa and Bani Israel crossed the sea or river, whatever it was. There is one opinion that it was one of the salt lakes. There were lakes, you know, between this Gulf of Suez in the south and the Mediterranean Sea. And lakes were there at different intervals. When the Suez Canal was dug, actually only this lake and this lake, intervening part of the area was dug. And the lakes were joined together so that a water channel come into existence. So one of the salt lakes, it is one's opinion, they crossed it. فَغَشِيَهُمْ مِنَ الْيَمِّ مَا غَشِيَهُمْ وَعَضَلَّ فِرْعَوْنُ قَوْمَهُ وَمَا هَدَى And Fir'aun led his people astray and didn't guide them to the right path. Ya Bani Israel, Now the address is to the children of Israel who have been saved. Ya Bani Israel, قَدْ أَنْجَيْنَاكُمْ مِنْ عَدُوِّكُمْ We have saved you and delivered you from your enemy. وَوَعَدْنَاكُمْ جَانِبِ الطُّورِ الْأَيْمَنَى And we called you for a covenant to the right side of the Mount Tur. وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى And we sent down on you for your dietary needs the man and salwa. Man was some honey-dew type of, you know, dew came down and then hardened. So it provided them the carbohydrates. And salwa was a bird. Flocks of those birds came down. So they very easily hunted them. So meat was provided by salwa and carbohydrates by man. They say that in the ark, which according to the Jews is still present, in a tunnel beneath Al-Qubbatu Sakhra in Jerusalem. And in that ark, Sunduq al-Sakina, there is a pot of man. Man is there. A sample is there in that ark. Up till this date. Kulu min tayyibati ma razaqnakum. Eat of the pure things that we have given you. There cannot be anything purer than this food which was coming from them. Wala tatghaw fihi. And don't cross the limits for them. Don't try to hoard them and collect them. But use it. And you fulfill your requirements. فَيَهِلَّ عَلَيْكُمْ غَضَبِي So then, you know, my chastisement will descend upon you. وَمَنْ يَهْلِلْ عَلَيْهِ غَضَبِي فَقَدْ هَوَى And on whomsoever my chastisement comes, then he perishes. He is doomed. وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَعْبَى And I am definitely forgiving for those, man taba, who repent, wa amana, and renew their iman, belief, wa amila salihan, and they do good deeds, summa tada, and then they are rightly guided. Now Hazrat Musa was called to Tur again, to give him Torah. And it was for 30 days or 40 days. He fasted for 40 days. And then Torah was given to him. But when he reached there, before the appointed time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala demanded an explanation. Why have you come before the appointed time? وَمَا عَجَلَكَ عَنْ قَوْمِكَ يَا مُوسَىٰ O Musa, what has made you hasten from your people? قَالَ هُمْ مُلَاءِ عَلَىٰ أَسَرِي He said, they are close upon my track. وَعَجِلْتُ إِلَيْكَ رَبِّ لِتَرْضَىٰ And I have come to you earlier, O my Lord, so that you are pleased with me. تُو میرا شوق دیکھ, میرا اشتیاق دیکھ, I have come earlier due to your love. I hoped that you will, you know, pay tribute to me, that I have come earlier. But here the matter is reverse. You are asking an explanation. قَالَ فَإِنَّا قَدْ فَتَنَّا قَوْمَكَ مِنْ بَعْدِكَ Now this is a very important point in Quran. Even for something good, you should not make haste. الْعُجْلَةُ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ We have read in Surah Taha, Surah Maryam, لَا تَعْجَلْ عَلَيْهِمْ Don't be hasty regarding these people. Don't want a hasty decision. A hasty command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَعْجَلْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مِنْ قَبْلِ يُقْضَى إِلَيْكَ وَحْيُهُ Don't demand that Quran should come to you hastily. No. We have read in Surah Maryam that the Prophet complained to Hazrat Jibreel, you are coming with very late, long intervals. You should come earlier. And he said, مَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ لَهُمَا بَيْنَا أَيْدِينَا وَمَا خَلْفَنَا وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ فَرَجَعَ مُوسَىٰ إِلَىٰ قَوْمِ قَالَ فَإِنَّا قَدْ فَتَنَّا قَوْمَكَ مِنْ بَعْدِكَ Allah said, we have tempted your people after you. وَعَضَ اللَّهُمُ السَّامَرِي And Samari has led them astray to worship the calf which he produced. فَرَجَعَ مُوسَىٰ إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ غَزْبَانَ آسِفَىٰ So Musa returned to his people when he was indignant, sorrowing. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَلَمْ يَعِدْكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ وَعَدٍ حَسَنًا He said, O my people, did not your Lord promise you a goodly promise? أَفَتَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأَحَدُ Has this time been very long upon you? أَمْ أَرَدْتُمْ أَنْ يَحِلَّ عَلَيْكُمْ غَضَبٌ Or you want that Allah's chastisement should come to you, مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ from your Lord, فَأَخْلَقْتُمْ وَعِدِي And then you did against what I had said to you. قَالُوا مَا أَخْلَفْنَا مُعِدَكَ بِمَلْكِنَا They said, we failed not in your appointment with our own intentions. وَلَكِنَّا هُمِّلْنَا عُزَارًا مِنَ ذِنَّةِ الْقَوْمِ But we were being laden by the ornaments of the people in Egypt. The Egyptians used to keep their ornaments in Bani Israel, that these are honest people, so as amanah in their custody. Now when they came, they brought all those ornaments with them. But then they thought that this is khayana. This is not correct for us. So they threw it. Samari collected all the gold and silver and melted it in fire. And from that, he created the shape of a calf, which gave a voice also, a sound also. And he said, he is the Lord of Moses. He just forgot. So they started, some of them, worshipping him. قَالُوا مَا أَخْلَفْنَا مَوْعِدَكَ بِمَلْكِنَا وَلَاكِنَّا هُمِّلْنَا عُزَارًا مِنَ الْقَوْمِ مِنْ زِنَةِ الْقَوْمِ We were laden with the ornaments of the people. فَقَذَفْنَا Then we threw them. فَقَذَالِكَ أَلْقَ السَّامَرِي In the same way Samari did it. فَأَخْرَجَ لَهُمْ عِجْلًا And then he formed from that, for them, a calf, jasadan, had a body of calf, lahu khuar, giving a law also. فَقَالُوا هَذَا إِلَهُكُمْ وَإِلَهُ مُوسَىٰ فَنَسِي And he said, this is the Lord, your Lord and Lord of Moses. thought of Musa, but he just forgot. Afala yarawna, didn't they see? Allah yarja'u ilayhim qawlan, that calf was not returning them, not talking to them, not replying to their questions. Wala yamliku lahum darran wala naf'a, and had no authority for them, for any good or any harm. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikri al-hakim. Wa laqad qala lahum Harun min qablu ya qawmi inna ma futintum bih wa inna rabbakum ar-Rahmanu fattabi'uni wa ati'u amri. Sadaqallahu al-Azim. And verily Harun alayhi salatu wa salam has told them before the coming of Moses, O my people, this is a test for you, a temptation for you. And your Lord is Ar-Rahman, the compassionate one. Fattabi'uni, so you follow me, wa atiyu amri, and obey my command. Qalu lan nabraha alayhi aakifin, they said, we will not cease to worship and cleave to it. Hatta yarji'a ilayna Musa, until Musa comes back to us. قَالَ يَا هَارُونُ مَا مَنَعَكَ إِذْ رَأَيْتَهُمْ ضَلُّوا وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَفَعَصَيْتَ أَمْرِي. Now Musa said alayhi salam to Harun alayhi salam, O Harun, what prevented you when you had seen them that they are going on the wrong path, that you didn't follow me? Did you disobey my command? قَالَ يَبْنَ أُمَّ لَا تَأْخُذْ بِلِحْيَتِي وَلَا بِرَاسِي. Harun said, O son of my mother, don't hold me, seize me with my beard and my head. Inni khashito, actually I feared, an taqula, lest you should say, farraqta baina bani Israel, Harun, you caused a division among the children of Israel. Walam tarqub qawli, and you didn't observe my word. Qala fama khatbuka ya samri. Now, after having this explanation from Harun alayhi salatu wasalam, now Hazrat Musa turns to Samri. Because this Samri was actually a spiritual person. Just as there was a Rahib, Abu Amir Rahib in the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was from the tribe of Khazraj. And he was a big saint. But he became enemy to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the other hand, we had Barqa ibn Nawfil. He was a big saint, big alim. But he supported Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this Samri was also a saint and a spiritual person. قَالَ فَمَا خَتْمُكَ يَا يَا Samri. Now Musa asked him, and what's your matter, O Samri? قَالَ بَصُرْتُ بِمَا لَمْ يَبْصُرُ. He said, I saw what they did not see. فَقَبِزْتُ قَبْزَةً مِّنْ أَسَرِ الرَّسُولِ. فَقَبِزْتُ قَبْزَةً مِّنْ أَسَرِ الرَّسُولِ. Then I took, seized a handful of dust from the messenger's footprints. Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, when he used to come to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he could see Jibreel because he himself was a spiritual person. He saw Jibreel coming and going. So from his footprints on the sand, he took some sand, and then he put this sand from the footprints of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam in that ornaments, you know, gold and silver. فَنَبَسْتُهَا وَكَذَلِكَ سَوَّلَتْ لِي نَفْسِي. So I cast it, and thus my mind guided me, enticed me. قَالَ فَزَبْ. Moses said, Hazrat Musa said, فَزَبْ. Go away. فَإِنَّ لَكَ فِي الْحَيَاةِ أَن تَقُولَ لَا مِسَاسِ. Your punishment for this, in this world, this life will be, that you will say to people, don't touch me. وَإِنَّ لَكَ مَوْعِدًا لَنْ تُخْلَفَ. And there is surely a promise with you which will be definitely fulfilled. And it will not fail. وَانْظُرْ إِلَّا الْإِلَٰهِكَ الَّذِي زَلْتَ عَلَيْهِ عَاكِفًا. Now see to your ilah, your God, that calf, for which now you had been, you were worshipping and cleaving to it. لَنُهْرِقَنَّهُ ثُمَّ لَنَنْصِفَنَّهُ فِي الْيَمِّ نَصْفًا. Now we shall burn it, then we shall certainly scatter the ashes into the sea. إِنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُ. Surely your Lord is Allah, and there is no Lord beside Him. وَسِعَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. He encompasses all the knowledge. كَذَلِكَ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ مَا قَدْ سَبَقَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this way, we are narrating to you the news and stories of those who had passed before you. وَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ مِنْ لَدُنَّا ذِكْرًا. And we have given you from our own self the admonition and the remembering. مَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهُ, whosoever will turn away from it, فَإِنَّهُ يَحْمِلُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وِزْرًا, he will surely bear a burden on the day of judgment. خَالِدِينَ فِيهِ, and they will remain forever in it. وَسَاءَ لَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ حِمْلًا, and very evil will be the load that they will be bearing on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection. يَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ, when the trumpet will be blown, وَنَحْشُرُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ زُرْقًا, and we shall gather all the guilty, blue-eyed with terror. Their eyes will turn blue due to fear and terror. يَتَخَافَتُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِن لَبِثْتُمْ إِلَّا عَشْرًا, and they will be whispering to each other that we didn't stay there but 10 days. Maybe in the world and in the alam barzakh, which we call, in our graves, we have been only for 10 days. Illa ashra. Nahnu alamu bima yaqulun. We very well know what they are saying. Is yaqulu amsaluhum tariqatan in labistum illa yawma. When the best of them in conduct says, we didn't stay there but one day. Wa yasalunaka anil jibal. And O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are asking you about the mountains. What will happen to mountains? You say that this land will be all plain. There will be no mountains. What will happen to these mountains? These mighty creatures and structures, what will happen to them? يَسَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ فَقُلْ يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفًا. Say, my Lord will scatter them with a total scattering as particles of dust. فَيَذَرُهَا قَانْ صَفْصَفًا, and then he will leave the earth as a plain, smooth level. لَا تَرَى فِيهَا عِوَجًا وَلَا أَمْتَى, in that earth you will not find any turnings or any mounts. يَوْمَيْذِي يَتَّبِعُونَ الدَّاعِيَ لَا عِوَجَ لَهُ, that day they will follow and they will respond to the caller, and they will be humbled. وَخَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتِ, their voices will be low before the compassionate. خَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلْرَحْمَانِ فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسَى, you will not be hearing except some murmuring and nothing else. يَوْمَئِذٍ لَا تَنْفَعُ الشَّفَاعَةُ إِلَّا مَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ الرَّحْمَانُ وَرَضِيَ لَهُ قَوْلًا, that day the intercession will not profit but from him whom the compassionate has granted leave and whose word he approves. يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ, he knows what is in front of them, what is behind them. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِهِ عِلْمًا, and they cannot comprehend anything from his knowledge. وَعَنَتِ الْوُجُوهُ لِلْحَجِّ الْقَيُّومِ, and the faces shall be humbled before the one who is ever living, eternal. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ حَمَلَ ظُلْمًا, and definitely those who will be carrying the burden of evil doing, they will be the people who will fail. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ, and whosoever commits good deeds, does good deeds, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ, and provided that he is a believer, فَلَا يَخَافُ ظُلْمًا وَلَا هَزْمًا, so he will not have any fear of any injustice done to him or any deprivation of his rewards. وَكَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا وَصَرَّفْنَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْوَعِيدِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ أَوْ يُحْدِثُ لَهُمْ ذِكْرًا, and in this way we have sent down this as a Quran, Arabic Quran, Quranan Arabiyan. وَصَرَّفْنَا فِيهِ, and we have explained in it all the threats in many ways, in different styles, in different words, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ, hoping that they may have taqwa, they may have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or yuhdithu lahum zikra, or some admonition might come to them. فَتَعَالَ اللَّهُ الْمَلِكُ الْحَقُّ. So exalted is Allah, who is the king, the true king. وَلَا تَعْجَلْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ يُقْضَى إِلَيْكَ وَحْيُهُ. The same thing which appeared in Surah Maryam also. And don't make haste for this Quran before the time that its revelation is completed to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal it to you gradually, bit by bit, part by part. وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. Otherwise, your quest for knowledge is commendable. So you should pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O my Lord, increase me in knowledge. قُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. وَلَقَدْ أَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ آدَمَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. And we had taken a covenant from Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam, before that. وَلَمْ نَجِدْ لَهُ فَنَزِيَا. He forgot. And we didn't find in him the firmness or resolve. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ. And recall when we said to all the angels, prostrate before Adam. So they all prostrated except Iblis. قُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ إِنَّ هَذَا عَدُوٌّ لَكَ وَلِزَوْجِكَ. We said, O Adam, this Iblis is an enemy for you and your wife. فَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّكُمَا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ فَتَشْقَى. So let him not expel you, get you expelled from the Jannah, from the garden. So then you will be in distress. إِنَّ لَكَ اللَّهَ تَجُوعَ فِيهَا وَلَا تَعْرَى. In this garden, surely it is granted and guaranteed for you that you shall not feel any hunger, nor go naked. وَأَنَّكَ لَا تَظْمَأُ فِيهَا وَلَا تَضْحَى. You shall not feel therein any thirst, nor suffer the sun, the heat of the sun. فَوَسْوَسَ إِلَيْهِ الشَّيْطَان. But Satan whispered to him, قَالَ يَا آدَم. He said, O Adam, هَلْ أَدُلُّكَ. Should I lead you? عَلَى شَجَرَةِ الْخُلْدِ. To the tree of eternity. وَمُلْكٍ لَا يَبْلَى. And a kingdom which will never decay and come to an end. فَأَكَلَا مِنْهَا. So now, on the instigation of Satan, both of them, Adam and Eve, they ate from the fruit of that forbidden tree. فَبَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا. Now their shame became manifested for them. It opened for them. فَتَفِقَا يَخْصِفَانِ عَلَيْهِمَا مِنْ وَرَخِ الْجَنَّةِ. And they started stitching upon themselves leaves from the garden. وَعَصَى آدَمُ رَبَّهُ. Verily, Adam disobeyed his Lord. فَغَوَى. And he erred. ثُمَّ اجْتَبَاهُ. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again chose him. فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. And he relented towards him. وَهَدَى. And guided him. قَالَ اهْبِطَا مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا. And said, now, all of you go down from this garden of heaven, hidden, and the paradise. بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوفٌ. Some of you will be the enemies of the others. An eternal enmity between Adam and his progeny on one hand, and Iblis and his armies on the other hand. This, you know, struggle is going on from the first day one, and it will continue to the last day. بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوفٌ. فَإِمَّا يَعْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًا. So whenever guidance comes to you from me, that is revelation, whenever I raise some prophet, send some messenger, and my guidance comes to him through revelation, فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ. So whosoever follows my guidance, فَلَا يَدِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. So he will not go astray, he will not lose the straight path, or not shall he be distressed. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ. And whosoever turns away from my remembrance, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَيْشَةً زَنْكًا. For them, the life in this world also be hardened and straightened. وَنَحْشَرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. And we shall raise him on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, in a blind form. قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَا حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا. And he shall say, O my Lord, why have you raised me up blind, while I used to see? قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيْتَهَا. Allah would say, in the same way our revelations came to you, but you ignored them, forgot them. وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. In the same way, today you will be forgotten. وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي مَنْ أَسْرَفَ. And in this way we reward the prodigals. وَلَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ. And who didn't believe in the ayat, in the revelations of his Lord. وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَشَدُّ وَأَبْقَى. And the chastisement of akhirah, of the hereafter, is very severe and everlasting. أَفَلَمْ يَهْدِ لَهُمْ كَمَا أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنَ الْقُرُونَ. Don't they have any guidance from the fact that how many a generation we destroyed before them? يَمْشُونَ فِي مَسَاكِنِهِمْ. They also used to walk in their cities and towns and dwellings. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِأُولِي النُّهَى. Verily, there are signs in this for those who have the reasoning power. وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ لَكَانَ لِزَامًا وَأَجَلٌ مُسَمَّى. لَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَأَجَلٌ مُسَمَّى. This is the real, you know, sequence. And had there not been that a word has already gone from your Lord, Allah has fixed a term, the chastisement to them will not come from that before that date. So that date has been fixed. لَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَأَجَلٌ مُسَمَّى. And had there been not that time fixed, لَكَانَ لِزَامًا, then you know the chastisements would have come to them. فَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ. So you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have perseverance on what they are saying. وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ. And you glorify your Lord with His praise. قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ. Before the rise of sun. وَقَبْلَ غُرُوبِهَا. And before its setting. وَمِنْ آنَائِ اللَّيْلِ. And from the hours during the night. فَسَبِّحْ. You must glorify. وَأَطْرَافَ النَّهَارِ. And on both the sides, both the ends of the day. لَعَلَّكَ تَرْضَى. So that you may be pleased. وَلَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ إِلَىٰ مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِّنْهُمْ. And don't cast your eyes towards the worldly wealth which we have given to some of them. زَهْرَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. This is the splendor of the life of this world only. لِنَفْتِنَهُمْ فِيهِ. And it is a testing for them. We are testing them in this wealth. وَرِزْقُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. And what your Lord has provided you is much better and lasting. We have read this ayah in Surah Al-Hijr also. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. We have given you the biggest wealth, and that is Surah Al-Fatiha, the seven ayat which are repeated in every prayer, every rak'ah, and Quran al-Azim. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. Now no worldly wealth is more precious than this gift of Allah to you, that is Quran and especially a Surah Al-Fatiha. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. And O Muhammad, keep commanding your family to establish Salah. وَاسْتَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. And you yourself also persevere on it. Establish the prayer. لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا. We don't ask you that you should feed us. نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ. We feed you. We supply everything to every living being. وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْتَّقْوَى. But the good end, the life of hereafter, that is for the God-fearing people. وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا يَعْتِينَا بِآيَةٍ مِّن رَبِّهِ. And they say, why does he not bring some sign from his Lord? Some miracle, just as the miracles of Jesus, miracles of Moses, miracles of Saleh. لَوْلَا يَعْتِينَا بِآيَةٍ مِّن رَبِّهِ. أَوَلَمْ تَعْتِهِمْ بَيَّنَةُ مَا فِي صُحْفِ الْأُولَى. Has not the clear teachings which was in the former scriptures come to them already in Quran? This is the biggest miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which He has given to Muhammad, Quran. And in this Quran, all the ancient teachings which came to all the messengers of Allah in the former scriptures, they are contained here. وَلَوْ أَنَّا أَهْلَكْنَاهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ مِّن قَبْلِهِ. And if we had destroyed them with a chastisement before this Quran was revealed, لَقَالُوا, then they would have said, رَبَّنَا لَوْلَا أَرْسَلْتَ إِلَيْنَا رَسُولًا. Our Lord, why didn't you send to us a messenger? فَنَتَّبِعَ آيَاتِكَ. we would have followed your revelations. Min qabli an nazilla wa nasza, before humiliation and degradation. Qul kullun mutarabbisun. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everyone is waiting. Fatarabbasu. So you also keep waiting. Fasata'lamun. Very soon you will come to know man ashabu sirat as-sawi. Who are those who are on the right path, on the even path, wa man ihtada, and who are rightly guided.